Hello everyone, today we will see about the Python variables. Variables is nothing but it is a colored index cards. There is no need to declare variable types. In C program you have to declare the variable type compulsorily. If you are not declaring the type, then it will throw the error. In Python you no need to declare any variable type. Suppose you want to declare a variable A, then you no need to declare the type, whether it is integer or float or string or character. You no need to declare the variable type because Python knows everything. Just we will see with one example. Just I am typing Python so that we came into the Python shell. Just I am typing the variable which is called A is equal to 10. So now I have assigned 10 in the variable A. I didn't declare which kind of data it is, either integer or float or character, whatever it is. Just I have simply declared A is equal to 10. Now I am just giving the print A. So if I give print A, it is just printing the value 10. So which means that you no need to declare the variable types. This Python know that what kind of data has been entered. So value is equal to 10 and print value if you give. So here the number 10 has been assigned in the variable value. If you give the print value, it will just print the value 10. See, again the value has been given 100.50. again I am giving A is equal to 100.50. again I didn't declare any type. Again I am giving printing. It is printing that value, which means so Python don't want to declare any variable with the type of data. So you can declare whatever you want to declare without the data type. You can declare the variable as a string also. For A, I am just declaring a string which is called this is string. This is for example I am typing. When you are declaring a string in Python, you should write it in the quotes, either in single quotes, double quotes or triple quotes. We will see it in the upcoming videos, what is the use of single quote, double quote and triple quote. Now again I am giving print A. So see, it is printing the string also. One more magic we will see. See here, print value star 3. The same command, if you give in C program, surely will get the error. Here you can see one magic. Here I have assigned A is equal to this is string. Now currently in the variable A, this is a string has been assigned. Now I am giving print A star 3. You see the magic, it is printing this is a string 3 times. This is not possible in C language and any other language, I don't know, but it is possible in Python. Means print value star 3. This star symbol is nothing but it is a repetition operator in Python. So next one is the input which will be get from the user. So here it is given name is equal to raw input, what is your name, and next one is the print statement. This one just we will see with one program. So just I have typed name is equal to raw underscore input. It is a predefined function in the Python. What is your name? I have just given which string has to be printed in the output screen. So what is your name? I have given here. You can give whatever you want. Next line I have given print hello comma name, where I have given here that variable I have assigned name comma welcome. I want to print it again. So I have typed this program and I have saved it. the name of test.py. Just I am running this program. So I am just typing python space test.py. So it is asking what is your name. So in the program you can see that in name we have just get the input, raw input from the user, what is your name we are asking. So it is asking your name. Just I am typing Maha. So see the output, hello Maha, welcome. So it is just printing hello in the name. Instead of name it is printing my name which I have given as the input, and it is printing welcome. So hello Maha, welcome is your output. So you have to get the inputs with the function of raw underscore input, very easy. And you no need to store it with the different variable. Just I am giving one variable where I am giving the input and storing it there only. So indentation is a very important concept in Python. It means you have to follow the order of your block of statements. If you are not following the indentation, like this policeman, the Python will beat you just for fun. You have to follow the indent properly, otherwise it will throw you the error. Why we have to go for the indentation? Because for the discipline. What discipline? Means each and every block of statement should follow the same spacing so that the program will looks very beautiful. Even the newcomer who will read your program can easily understand where the program or where the block is starting, where the for loop is starting, where the if condition is starting, by seeing your indentation. So that's why it is required. In next video we will see how to download the Python and how to run the Python in Windows.